Now, for improper fractions, if you want to arrange them in ascending order, you should start with the least fraction onwards. Yes or no? In improper fraction, which will be the least fraction? With number? Highest, largest one. Yes or no? Take only numerators or only denominators, whatever it is. What is the largest one? 108 by 101. Yes or no? 108 by 101 is the number which has the largest number. Hence it becomes least fraction. Yes or no? Next, 89 by 82. This is second least. Next, third least, second largest, and then largest. Got it? Followed? Now, proper and improper. In proper fraction, what could be the least number? No, I am not talking about fraction. I am in general talking about number system. What could be the expected least number that exists in proper fraction? First of all, one is improper fraction. One is improper fraction. Don't you know that? I already asked you. What do you mean by proper fraction? What do you mean by proper fraction? Numbers in the form of P by Q, where numerator is strictly less than denominator. They are called proper fractions. And improper fractions? Improper fractions. Numbers in the form of P by Q, where numerator is greater than or equal to denominator. Now mixed fraction. Mixed fraction. Combination of integer and fraction. Combination of integer and fraction. A, B by C in the sense, A plus B by C, right? See, you will say 2, 1 by 3 as mixed fraction example. 2, 1 by 3. 2, 1 by 3 in the sense, is it 2 plus 1 by 3 or not? What is this? Integer. What is this? Fraction. That is combination of integer and fraction. Yes or no? If numerator is strictly less than denominator, that is proper. If numerator is greater than or equal, then it is improper. Okay. Are you done? Now tell me, what could be the expected least number that exists in proper fraction? Minus infinity. Minus infinity. That is the least number that exists in proper fraction. And in improper fraction, remember, I am talking about this. And in improper fraction, largest number? Plus infinity. Plus infinity. And in improper fraction, improper I am talking about. Least number that exists? Are you sure? 1. 1 is the least number that exists in improper. Largest is positive infinity. And in proper fraction, what could be the largest number? 0.9 bar. 0.9 bar. So, 3 years back or 4 years back, I don't remember exactly, there was a question. 7 by 9, 8 by 11, numbers are different, but I am writing the concept actually. 17 by 21, 18 by 23, 4 by 5, 1 by 3. You will not have none of these as options in your examination. Right. What is the answer for this question? Come on. If you can understand this, you will be done. How many fractions are there? Are these all proper fractions or improper fractions? Proper or improper? See, for any proper fraction, the largest value itself will be 0.9 baht. Should be definitely less than 1. Yes or no? This value should be definitely less than 1. Less than 1. Less than 1. Less than 1. Like that, how many fractions are there? 6. Then sum will be definitely less than 6. Any proper fraction value should be definitely less than 1. There are 6 proper fractions. Sum should be definitely less than 6. Do you have any option? Answer none of these. Are you getting? To answer this question, the basic idea is largest number and least number that exists in proper and improper. In proper fraction, value will be definitely less than 1. Value should be definitely less than 1. There are 6 proper fractions. Sum should be definitely less than 6. There is no other option. You can eliminate all. Answer, none of this. Are you getting? See, I don't know exact answer for this question. I don't know exact answer for this question. Will be somewhere around 3 or 4 or something will come. If I know that, in place of none of this, I will write that number. Maybe 4, some x by y. In place of x and y, you should have some number. If I know the exact number, I'll keep it in fifth option, E. So with the same logic, as a number, sum of 6 proper fractions should be less than 6, answer should be fifth option. Done. Are you getting? Right. So these type of questions also will come based on fractions. Remember, 3 years back or 4 years back, with the same concept we have a question, with the same concept, based on maximum value and minimum value in proper and improper fractions. Okay? Right. Now, multiplication and division for fractions is very easy. Fraction multiplication or division? Anybody should try to identify cancellations. That's it. Cannot be done anything. We should identify factors here. Anyone should find factors and need to go for cancellation. Answer 1 by 6. And if you have 1 by 2 divided by 3 by 4 into 5 by 6 divided by 8 by 10. Something like that. What to do? Combination of multiplications and divisions. You should try to convert divided by 3 by 4 and divided by 8 by 10 as multiplication. If you interchange symbol, you know that you have to take inverse of it. Into 5 by 6. Divided by 8 by 10 we have, you should write it as into 10 by 8. Make sure you have only multiplication symbols in your expression and then try to identify cancellation. That's it. Clear everybody? Sure? Right. Now, mixed fractions, additions and subtractions. You will have total 8 models as I discussed. 4 in proper fractions, 4 in improper fractions. Improper fraction. Now, you will not understand what my model name is, but when getting answer, you will understand. Models are plus plus proper fraction, plus minus proper fraction, minus plus proper fraction, minus minus proper fraction. Same case with improper also. plus plus improper fraction plus minus improper fraction minus plus improper fraction minus minus improper fraction. I'll discuss about these symbols. Now this is about mixed fraction addition. This is about mixed fraction addition. Now look at this. This is plus plus proper fraction. 8 1 by 7 plus 2 1 by 3 plus 5 1 by 2. This is one combination. Let me write any other one. 21 1 by 4 plus 5 1 by 2 minus 3 1 by 3. Let me take first set. See, people will try to convert mixed fraction to improper and they will try to take LCM of denominators. Nothing is required. 8 1 by 7 can be written as 8 plus 1 by 7. Consider only integers first. Take only integers. Forget about fractions. Only integers. 8 plus 2 plus 5. How much? 15. Now, take LCM of denominators in fractions. 7, 3, 2. How much? 42. 7 how many times? 6 times. 3 how many times? 14 times. 2 how many times? 21 times. 6 plus 14? 20. 20 plus 21? 41. So, that becomes 15. 41 by 42. Come on, next, continue. The other part. 21 plus 5. 26. Minus 3. 23. Plus LCM of denominators. 12. 4 how many times? 3 times. 2 how many times? 6 times. 3. 4 times. Answer 23. Come on. 5 by 12. Why are we calling this as plus plus proper fraction? Now I will tell. Come on. This is first case. Plus plus proper fraction. Here, the first sign represents sign for integer. Sign for integer. What is that we are getting here? Positive or negative?
Positive.
And here?
Positive.
Hence, the first sign represents positive symbol. And for fraction, what is that we are getting?
Positive.
And here also?
Positive.
What fraction we got? Proper fraction or improper fraction?
Proper.
Come on.
Proper.
And here also?
Proper.
So, sign for integer is positive. Sign for fraction is positive. And fraction obtained is proper fraction. Are we getting positive sign for integer in both the cases? And for fraction also, are we getting positive sign? Yes. Is the fraction is equal to proper fraction? Yes. Hence, this is called plus plus proper fraction. You will not understand what is advantage with plus plus proper fraction and naming. Once you are done with four models, then you will understand. Okay? Right. You want one more example in this set? Yes or no? Let me give you one more example. 17 1 by 2 plus 13 1 by 3 minus 24 1 by 4. Come on, do it. 17 plus 13?
30.
30. 30 minus 24? Plus symbol? Right. And then LCM of denominators?
12.
6 times? 4 times? 3 times. How much? 6? 7 by 12. Positive symbol for integer. Positive symbol for fraction. And the fraction obtained is proper fraction. Okay? Sure. Now, come on, only integers. 15 minus 1 minus 2, how much? 12 plus LCM 24. 12 ones minus 3, 8 times, 8 twos 16 minus 8, how many times? 3 times. Minus 19 plus 1. Minus 18. Minus 18 by 24. 18 by 24. Cancellation with 6. That becomes 3 by plus or minus? Right. 12 minus 3 by 4. Yes or no? 12 minus 3 by 4. Now what is sign for integer? Sign for integer? Plus. And for fraction?
Minus.
Which fraction is that? Proper or improper? Proper. Second model. Sign for integer plus. For fraction? Minus. And it is proper fraction. So now, when you have plus, minus, proper fraction, whatever the integer you have, reduce it by 1, reduce it by 1, difference of numerator and denominator by denominator. This is your answer. Whatever integer you have, reduce it by 1. Difference of numerator and denominator by denominator is your answer. I will explain the logic also. How much integer we have? Reduce it by 1. Difference of numerator and denominator by denominator? 11, 1 by 4. That is your answer. What is happening? This is what you have. Yes or no? Can I write this 12 as 11 plus 1? Yes or no? And then minus 4 we have. Take this combination. 1 minus 3 by 4. How much is that? 1 by 4. 11 plus 1 by 4. 11, 1 by 4. This is what happening there. You are taking 1 from original integer. Original integer is 12. You are taking 1 here. Remaining is? Come on. What is remaining? 11. 1 minus 3 by 4? 1 by 4. Okay? Sure everybody? This is what you need to remember. Whatever integer you have, reduce it by 1. Difference by denominator. Followed? Come on. Right, next. (21, 1/8, + 3, 1/9, - 7) 1 by 2. 7, 1 by 2. Right, only integers first. 24 minus 7. 17. Plus LCM. 72. 8 how many times? 9 times. 9 how many times? 8 times. Minus 2 how many times? 30. 6 times. How much is this? 17 minus 9 plus 8. 17. 17 minus 36. How much? 19 by 72. Come on. Integer? Positive. Fraction? Negative. And which fraction? Proper fraction. Right. When you have plus minus proper fraction, what did we discuss? Reduce integer by 1. How much it becomes? 16. And then? And then? Difference by numerator and denominator. How much is that? 53 by denominator. Reduce integer by 1 and difference of numerator and denominator by denominator. Okay? Right. Next. 7 1 by 7. 5 1 by 5. 3 1 by 3. Come on. Integer 7 plus 5, 12, 12 minus 3, 9, LCM 105, denominator all numbers are prime numbers, so that is 105, yes or no? Come on, how much is that? 7, how many times? 15 times, 5 how many times? 21 times, minus 30. 5 will take 2 by 3, 3 2 by 3, 3 2 by 3, how much? 70. Now it becomes 9, 36 minus 70, minus 34 by 105. Integer, positive, fraction, negative, and which fraction? Proper fraction, plus minus proper fraction. How much is that? Reduce integer by 1. Difference of numerator and denominator. By denominator. Yes. 71 by 105. How many examples are there? 3. Fine. You want one more or enough? Right. We'll go for next model. Right. Minus plus proper fraction. 37, 1 by 5, plus 2, 1 by 3, minus 45, 2 by 15. Only integer. 37 plus 2, 39. 39 minus 45? Minus 6. LCM? 15. 3 times? 5 times? And then? 15 once and then you have minus 2. So how much is this? Minus 6 plus 6 by 15 can be written as? 6 by 15 can be written as 2 by 5. Now, integer, negative, fraction, positive. Which fraction is that? Proper fraction. Integer, negative, fraction, positive. And the fraction is proper fraction. Followed? Yes or no? Right. Now, we will apply the same concept here. Even when you have minus plus proper fraction, reduce integer by 1, minus plus proper fraction. Whatever integer you have, reduce it by 1, difference of numerator and denominator by denominator. Whatever the sign is there for integer, same sign applies for answer. Earlier we have plus, minus, proper fraction. There also, reducing integer by 1, difference of numerator and denominator by denominator. As sign for integer is positive, for answer also it will be positive. The model is same. If it is plus for integer, answer also will have plus. If it is negative symbol for integer, answer also will have negative symbol. Got it? Come on. Come on, tell me. Minus? Minus? 5? 3 by? 5. Minus? I did not ask you to subtract. I asked you to reduce. Subtraction is different. Reduction is different. Subtract in the sense, straight forward minus 1. Reduce in the sense, number reduces by 1. That becomes 5 only. The actual concept, what is happening here? Look at this. I'll explain. Minus 6 plus 2 by 5 we have. I can write minus 6 as minus 5 minus 1 plus 2 by 5. Let me take combination for this. Then it is minus 5. If you take 5 common, that is minus 5 plus 2 comes in numerator. Yes or no? How much is that? Minus? Minus? 3 by 5. If integer is positive, negative and fraction is negative, finally it becomes minus of 5, 3 by 5. Yes or no? If both are negative, mixed fraction is also negative. Come on. This negative symbol is applicable for integer and fraction both. Agreed or not? Right. This is what happening here also. Whatever integer we have, reduce it by 1. Face value only. Not subtraction. Reduction. Okay. Minus 6 becomes minus 5. And difference of numerator by denominator. As a symbol for integer is negative, answer also becomes negative. Got it? Sure? Right, let's have one more example. This is minus plus, right? Minus plus. 3, 3 by 4, minus 2, 1 by 12, minus 5, 1 by 16. Integers, come on. 3 minus 2 minus 5, how much is that? Minus 4. LCM? 48. 4 how many times? 12 times. 12 threes? 36. Minus 12? 4 times. 16? 3 times. 36 minus 7, how much is that? 36 minus 7? 29. Minus plus proper fraction. Yes or no? Symbol for integer, negative. Fraction, positive. Fraction obtained, proper fraction. Now, reduce it by 1. 3. Difference of numerator and denominator? 19. By denominator, 48. Symbol for integer, negative. For answer also, negative. Understood? Right. Let me give you one more example. Minus plus. 13 5 by 6 minus 2 1 by 12, or let me take 12 1 by 12 minus 15 1 by 15. 13 minus 12 minus 15, how much? Minus 14. LCM of denominator 60. 50 times, 5 times, 4 times. How much is that? 50 minus 9. 41. 41 by 60. Come on, reduce it by 1. 13. Difference of numerator and denominator? 19 by 60. Symbol for integer? Negative. So here also negative. Got it? Sure. Right. Next, last model, improper fraction. Minus, minus proper fractions. Minus, minus proper fractions. 2 1 by 18 plus 3 1 by 9 minus 9 1 by 2. Come on, integers. Minus 4. And LCM? 18. 1 plus 2 minus 9. 1 plus 2, 3. 3 minus 9? Minus 6. Minus 6 by 18? Minus 6 by 18? Minus 1 by 3. Yes or no? Minus 1 by 3. What is symbol for integer? Negative. Fraction? Negative. And which fraction? See, if both are negative, then answer becomes negative. And direct it becomes 4, 1 by 3. Yes or no? Minus 4, minus 1 by 3. Becomes minus 4, 1 by 3 or not? Over. Next. 17, 1 by 24. Minus 9, 1 by 18. Minus 12, 1 by 3. 17 minus 21, minus 4, LCM. LCM, 72. LCM, 72. 24 how many times? 3 times. 18 how many times? 4 times. 3 how many times? 24 times. Total? Minus 25 by 72. Agreed? Minus 25 by 72. Minus 25 by 72. Both are negative? Answer becomes negative. Minus 4 minus 25 by 72 can be written as 4 25 by 72. Followed? Yes. One more example? Sure? Right. So overall concept I'll explain now. Plus plus proper fraction is one set. Similarly, minus minus proper fraction is another set. Got it? So something like, here you will get A plus B by C, plus plus proper fraction. Answer becomes positive, which is A B by C direct. Got it? This is plus plus proper fraction. And similarly, minus minus proper fraction will be there. That is, minus A minus b by c, that becomes answer negative a b by c. That's what happened. If you want, you can revise it. If you want, you can revise it. Is it clear? These two are one set. Plus plus proper, minus minus proper. Similarly, plus minus proper fraction, minus plus proper fraction. These two are similar sets. So what happens here? Here you'll have A minus B by C. Yes? Now you will decrease A by 1, difference of numerator and denominator by denominator. That is your answer. As the symbol for integer is positive, answer also becomes positive. Arrow down by 1. Did you understand the meaning? Reduce it by 1. Arrow down by 1. Got it? Next. Minus A plus B by C. Minus A plus B by C. Here also, reduce integer by 1. Difference of numerator and denominator by denominator. As the symbol for integer is negative, answer also negative. Is this we are following or not? Yes? So plus plus proper, minus minus proper. Those two are one set. Plus minus proper fraction, minus plus proper fraction. These two are similar sets. Followed? Any confusion? Sure? Right. Now, plus plus improper fractions. Plus plus improper. 1 1 by 2, 2 2 by 3, 3 3 by 4. Come on. Concept is same. We will add first integers and then we will take fractions. Okay. Come on, add all integers. 1, 2, 3. How much? 6. LCM? 12. 2 how many times? 6 times. 3? 4 times. But 4 twos? 8. And then 4 how many times? 3 times. But 3 threes? 9. How much is that? 6 plus 8 plus 9, 23. Symbol for integer, fraction in fraction symbol, positive. And which fraction is that? Improper fraction. Hence it is plus plus improper fraction. Okay, plus plus improper. Now, can we write this 23 by 12 as 1 11 by 12? Yes or no? Now let's again add integers. Again add integers. 6 plus 1. How much? 7. And then 11 by 12. Just need to convert this to mixed fraction. Convert improper fraction to mixed fraction. Is it okay? Everybody? Come on. 21, 1 by 30. Plus 5 by 6. Plus 3, 4 by 15. Right, come on. Integers. 21, 5, 3. How much? Amma? 29. And LCM? 30. Come on. 30. How much? Once. 25. And then? 8. 26 plus 8. 34 by 30. 34 by 30 can be written as 17 by 15. Matladru. Entire value is 34 by 30. Now you can convert 34 by 30 as 17 by 15. That is again 1, 2 by 15. Yes. 1, 2 by 15 is again 1 plus 2 by 15. So total value becomes 29 plus 1, that is 30, and then 2 by 15. Are you following? Yes. The only thing that you have to do extra work here is need to convert improper fraction to mixed fraction, improper to mixed fraction, and then need to add integers again. Yes or no? Right. Is it fine or you want one more? One more. Right. Plus plus improper, right? 3, 7 by 20 plus 4, 2 by 5 plus 5, 3 by 4. Come on. 3 plus 4 plus 5. 12. 20. 7. 5, 4 times, 4 2 is 8. 7 plus 8, 15. 4 how many times? 5 times. 5 3 is 15. 15 plus 15? Come on. 30. 30 by 20 can be written as 3 by 2. 1, 1 by 2, 12 plus 1, 1 by 2, 13, 1 by 2. Got it? Next. Let's complete minus minus improper, okay? Let's complete minus minus improper because these two together are a set. 11, 11 by 143 minus 8, 10 by 11 minus 9, 2 by 30. Okay? Come on. Integers. 11 minus 17 minus 6. LCM? 143. 11 minus. 11 how many times is 143? 13. 13 into 10? 130. Minus 13 how many times? 11 times. Wait a minute. Take this number as 3. 3 by 13. Right. 13 how many times? 11 times. 11 3 is 33. So finally it becomes minus 6. Minus 152. By 143 minus 152 by 143. Integer negative, fraction negative, and fraction is improper. Let's convert improper fraction to mixed fraction. Mixed fraction 152 by 143 can be written as how much? 19 by 143. Yes or no? 19 by 143. Both are negative? Both integer and fraction? Answer negative? That is 79 by 143. 79 by 143. Over. Come on. Next. 5 by 56. 6, 6 by 7, 7, 7 by 8. Integers, minus 8, LCM 56, 5, minus 7, how many times? 8 times. 8 into 6? 48. Minus 8, how many times? 7 times. 7 sevens? 49. So this becomes minus 8. Minus, how much is this sum? Minus 92. Minus 92. See, 92 by 56 can be written as 1 subtract 56, 36. 36 by 56 in the sense 18 by 28. Again 9 by 14. 9 by 14. 92 by 56 can be written as 1, 9 by 14. Minus 1. 9 by 14. Both are negative? Answer is negative. Add integers. Add integers. 9. 9 by 14. This is the only extra step. You have to convert improper fraction to mixed fraction. And then again we need to add integer. Yes. One more? No. Not required. So what is happening in plus plus improper fraction? And minus minus improper fraction? Answer will be positive here. And here also negative. Now you need to add two integers and numerator by denominator. Here also you need to take sum of two integers and numerator by denominator. From where we get the second integer? From where we will get second integer? By converting improper fraction to mixed fraction, we will get integer. Yes or no? By converting improper fraction to mixed fraction, we will get again one more integer. So we have to add both the integers. Whatever sign we have there for integer, the same follows for your answer also. Okay? Sure. Right. We have two more. Plus minus improper fraction. Minus plus improper fraction. We'll continue this tomorrow. Okay?